back here with another exciting tutorial to get you through the doldrums of the office workday without too much anguish. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a digital signature in Adobe Acrobat Reader DC. The program is free and can be downloaded at adobe.com's website, as you can see on the screen. What is Acrobat Reader? It's a program by Adobe that allows you to view and fill in PDF forms created with Adobe Acrobat and Adobe Lifecycle. PDF stands for Portable Document Format and is a popular way to share documents and forms across the web when other programs like Microsoft Word or Excel just won't do. Great, right? But why do you need a digital signature for these documents? Often, you need to certify that the information on a document is correct when you can't be there in person. A digital signature that locks a document lets the reader know the information you sent to them hasn't been edited by anyone but you. Digital signatures have the power to lock a document if the creator set it up correctly. Now, on to creating and signing a document. First, open Acrobat Reader. Navigate to the Edit on the menu and select Preferences at the bottom. For a pro tip, press Ctrl plus K on your keyboard to bring up the Preferences window. Once on the Preferences window, under the Categories section on the left side, choose Signatures. Then, on the right-hand side, under Identities and Trusted Certificates, click the More button. Under the Digital ID and Trusted Certificate Settings window that pops up, ensure the Digital ID's category is selected and click Add ID. A new window pops up. Add Digital ID. Choose a new Digital ID I want to create now and click Next. Choose New PCKS Number 12 Digital File ID and click Next. Now, fill in the pertinent details of your digital ID. For name, enter your full name. For organizational unit, enter something like human resources or accounting. For the organization name, enter the name of your company, such as ABC Widgets. For an email address, enter your email address. Choose your country or region if the default setting is not correct, and leave the key algorithm at its default value. Under Use Digital ID For, choose Digital Signatures. Click Next once you're all done. If you make a mistake, you can always click the Back button. Now, you need to create a password only you know for your digital signature. Type it once in the password box, and then again in the Confirm password box. I recommend leaving the file name field set at its default. When you've finished entering your password, click Finish. Your new ID shows up in the window, and it can now be used to digitally sign documents. For the purposes of this tutorial, I've created a simple document with a text field you can fill in and a digital signature field that will lock the text field once I sign it with my new signature. I'll open my awesome certification document and start filling in the details. Once I have the name and date in there, I click on my Certifier Signature field and Reader brings up a list containing my digital IDs. Click on the ID you just created, click Continue, and enter the password you set up for this ID. Click Sign. Save the signed document on your hard drive in a location of your choosing. I'll choose the desktop here and click Save. Your document shows up signed and is now locked for editing. Note when I try to click on any of the fields to edit them, I can't. Should you need to go back and update the document later, right-click on your signature and choose Clear Signature. The document fields immediately unlock and you can edit the form again until you re-sign it. Note that only the person who created the signature can clear it from the document. Thus, it's important not to share your computer account with anyone, as they could potentially clear your signatures from important documents. I'm not sure why someone would do that, but the world today also has the pet rock and jump to conclusions, Matt. That's it. You've created your signature, signed your document, and have a giant look of satisfaction on your face, or at least a bit less chagrin about not getting your TPS reports in on time. If you found this tutorial useful, remember to subscribe to my channel for more tutorials and share it with your friends and coworkers. That way, they won't keep bugging you to show them how to create a digital signature, and we can all get back to browsing Pinterest for neat ways to use old sock. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.